A very warm welcome to the Sengkang Hockey Complex, where it's the World League Round 1 taking place. This, the men's pool, and it will be Pool A, and what a pulsating game this should be. Hong Kong, formerly of China, now handed back after British rule. They will take on China. That, of course, happened back in 97 when the handover took place. However, there is a big, big rivalry here between these two nations to see who will come out on top. Will it be China or will it be Hong Kong? The handshakes all round shows that there is a friendly atmosphere here. However, it is China that have absolutely demolished anything that has come in their way so far. An 11-0 victory over Vietnam, an 11-1 victory over Thailand shows that they are the side to take on and try and beat. Ranked 6th in Asia compared with Hong Kong that are ranked 13th. 19th in the world for China compared with 52 for Hong Kong. That being said, it doesn't tell you everything you need to know. It is a very, very young Chinese side that has been sent out here by Song Yi, the head coach. Basically an under-21s. There are only three players that are 22 years old that are in this squad. So very much looking at this first round of the World League Hockey to put out the youngsters and give them the opportunity to perform and play at this level. China will be in the green strip today, or the turquoise strip, I think it's fair to say. Fortunately, it has cooled down somewhat. It was on the pitch 45 degrees Celsius earlier on, dropped to about 42 at half time. Now it's a little bit cooler, so it's a little bit more humid, and that has come in, and you will see the players really trying to push themselves all the way here. It should be a tough encounter and a tough ask for Hong Kong. China very much the favourites going into this one. There is another Pool A game going on at the moment, the penultimate game for Vietnam and Thailand. As well, it's Vietnam's penultimate game. They are currently losing by 3-0. The Thais looking very, very strong as well. Thailand take on Hong Kong in their final group game, and you feel that that could decide who will finish second in Pool A and have an opportunity to push themselves through. Straight away then, it's China that get us underway, hitting from left to right in that green strip, and easily Meng Daihao with a big scoop forwards. However, a little bit off the ball there from Su Kai-jun means the possession turned over straight away. China looking to press high up the field of play as well. There are a lot of green shirts there applying a lot of pressure to this Hong Kong side. A very disciplined China side, that much we know. Nice little touch there on that occasion though. Lo Si-hon just chopping and changing the angle. Usman Ali will get going. He got a goal against Vietnam. Hong Kong looking to come out from the back. Si Man-chun fires it into the middle of the park. It's not a bad ball either. Helped on nicely into the path of Yu Chi-wai. He loses out though. Strong from Meng Lei, the skipper. Good stick work from him. He keeps possession. Only 20 years old, already amassed 40 caps before going into this event. This is China's third game, so he'll win his 43rd cap throughout this campaign. And that's what it will stand for today. There's a ball that's drilled into the air. Took a little deflection, so it's going to be a hit for Hong Kong. It's a bright start from the Hong Kong side. Nicely held down the line. Wang Boyen tries to get the better of his man, but couldn't. Well defended, well kept by the Chinese as they look to break forwards now. A little bit of time and space. That's really good play and helped on lovely. That's brilliant play from China, and it's the opening goal. And it's come just 3 minutes in. Well, they turned defence into attack very, very quickly. And that is how lethal this Chinese side is. Stunning play from China then. And within 3 minutes, they put themselves in front. Yi Wenhui has been given the goal. That's his second of the tournament as well. And it's come against the run of play. It was Hong Kong that were pushing as they go with a high press. However, good stick work there from Chang Taotiu. He scoops it in. Given away, though. Well defended by Li Wangqiu. Well, that's a bit of a hammer blow to Hong Kong. Well picked up there. Hang Boen helps it forwards. Meng Daihao with a little bit of time and space and drills it goalbound, but it's just wide. Flashes past the post. That ball just asking a little bit too much there of Win for Montong. So China will look to build from back. Wang Dingtiang just keeping it simple. Meng Dihao. It's good movements and real injection in this is Yi Wenhui. Lovely ball back inside. They get the hits as well. They were looking for the short corner. Not given, though. Oh, that's lovely stick work. And good play. And that is the first short corner of the game. And it goes in favour of China. You just wonder if it's going to be containment from Hong Kong. They had started very attack-minded. So the injector is Yi Wenhui. He will look to pull this to the edge of the D. There are options there for China. Nicely pulled back and a good scoop forwards. A good save in the end, but it's just tucked home again by the number nine, Yi Wenhui. The right place at the right time means he gets his second of the game. And that with just 6 minutes on the clock. It's China that are looking strong here. A little bit of a pull, said the official, so play taken quickly. Wang Jingtiang trying to get on with things, but couldn't. The ball will get pushed back, and it will be Huang that gets things back underway. Spanked out to that far side, and a lovely little turn there as well from Guo Qixiang. He drives into the byline, looks to pull it back, and wins another short corner. Oh, Hong Kong up against it already here. The Chinese side looking dominant, as you would expect. Their ranking does reflect that, even though it is a young side. It's pulled back, scoop forwards, that hits the chest. That goes in favour of Hong Kong, quite correctly so as well. And the clock will stop. Kane, the pace that some of these players are striking the ball is ferocious. Can't see who that is down. I think it's Yu Chi-Wai that took one to the chest. Get the ice straight on that. In fact, it was Li Wangqiu who just got caught. Brave closing down. He had to do it as well. So Hong Kong make a change. Nicely tucked forward. A little bit of time for Gabriel Tsui. He loses out though, so trying to get on with things quickly is Yiwen Hui again. Keeps it simple. That's better defending from Hong Kong. Chen Ka-chun doing ever so well to cut that one out. That's well won back though, and good stick work shown from Go Chi Xiang. Hong Kong can breathe a sigh of relief as they win the hit. Man Chun. It's a long ball forwards. It's asking an awful lot though of win for Mantong. China looking very, very comfortable and accomplished here. Meng Lei fired out wide into the path of Wu Tiahui, who in turn plays it back in. That's a deft little touch as well from Lin Cheng Liang. Wonderful little reverse flick from him, almost coming off. China working incredibly hard. Su Kai Jun losing out. The umpires working together on that occasion. Good pressure from China, however. That was well played initially from Lo Sihan. So Ali scoops that ball forwards. Chinese side very comfortable stroking this one around. Go Ti Xiang keeps it simple. Just tucked up the line. A nice little touch as well. Meng Diao. He wins the hit. Into the D, and what a strike that was, and a stunning save in the end. Michael Chung in goal. Pulls one right out of the top draw as China keep looking to go forwards. Meng Lei. Yiwen Hui losing out on that occasion and just being told no more nonsense. Well, it is a Chinese side that got through to the semi-finals of the World League, the last edition. They finished 10th in the classification after losing to Poland. And already you can see that they are looking a very strong outfit here, as it's short corner number 3 going their way. So we've already seen that they do have power and pace. And again, Yiwen Hui will be entrusted in delivering the ball to the edge of the D. It's got good pace on it. It's well played. It's a cool, calm finish as well. Scooped through the onrushing crowd and getting his name on the score sheet with what was a fantastic finish, giving the keeper absolutely no chance. Lin Tian Liang. So 3-0 in favour of China. Just a little bit too far. So it should be China that we are looking very, very comfortable here.
fired out wide. Wu Tiahui just loses out on the touch. It was Manali having to trap back and put the challenge in. It's a lovely little reverse pass as well. Fired high and over the top, though, from Lin Chenliang. Hong Kong trying to stroke it around. The big full press coming in from China, though, but that's good play from Lo Sihan. He loses out, though, and in the end, it's picked up by Ismanali. Advantage played. Fired wide from Almaziz. Doesn't keep possession, though. So that's somewhat sloppy. Again, it's a lot to do with possession and the lack of turnovers. Unless you're creating opportunities, of course. It's the cheap turnovers that everybody looks at. Huang Jintieng helps it down the line. It's a fantastic ball as well. Wang Xiaowei driving into the D and winning the long corner. Hong Kong forced to defend. Goes to Xiang. Wins the hit again. It's a nice ball played back in. Play continues though. Fired away fortuitously from Galbio Soy. UTY tries to help it on but just can't get it forward. So China having a siege mentality at the moment and making it very difficult for Hong Kong to get out their own half. Is Wu again. Huang. Just keeping it simple. Good defending in the end from Kwok Chun Thing. Just losing out there was Wang Boyen. Here's Wang Boyen again. Looking to drive into the deep. Flicks it forwards. A little turn and reverse shot. Not a million miles away. Su Lixiang just trying to create that yard for himself. Just not enough, though. So it's Hong Kong that will hit in. It's a lovely little touch out wide. Not enough runners going forwards, though. Chen Kaichun wanting options. They weren't there. That's a lovely reverse ball forward. Su Lixiang trying to create a yard for himself. Well defended though from Hong Kong. Just pushed away to safety. Osman Ali with the ball back inside. Su Chunming closed down quickly. Tried to play down the line. Well read though from Gu Haifeng. Once again, China just stopped the threat. Hong Kong funnel everybody back into their own half. Not as expansive as the opening five or so minutes. Nice little touchdown from Wang Xiaowei. Keeps it simple. Gu Tixiang. Wang Boyen. Good stick work there from Wang Boyen. It's on with things quickly. Again, dribbles into the D. Oh, they were just looking for the reverse shot there. It just didn't transpire though. Well defended from Hong Kong. Nice ball played forwards and a nice little touch there, Yu Chi Wai. Wanted the hit as it is. It's gone out, so they'll still retain possession. Wang Jingtian just putting himself there to make it difficult. Usman Ali with a ball in. Comfortable and easily dealt with by Wang Jingtian. Well, good play there from Cheng Tiwan. Just waited for the contact to come. Gu Haifeng waits for the support as well. That's a blistering run down the flank from Meng Lei. Skipper doing well. Hong Kong happy just to hack it away to safety. Good touch from Go Hai Feng into the D. And another short corner. So short corner number four for China. They currently lead by 3-0. Just under 17 minutes to go. A little bit of cloud cover now has given us a break from the sunshine that we had earlier. It's all looking sunny for China at the moment as they look to increase their lead. Pull back to the edge. It's a good stop. Scoop forwards. It's fallen for Cheng. Brilliant save in the end. Really good stuff there from Michael Chung in goal, the 21-year-old. Called to task and a good save. That's a lovely bit of stick work into the far post area. Looking on the turn, it's Wang, pulls it back. Drilled home, absolutely no mistake there. And no prisoners taken with that finish. Good work from Wang Bowen. And that is a cool, calm finish. No mistakes whatsoever from Yi Qin. He gets his first of the tournament, but more importantly, gives China a 4-0 lead. Wang Boyan. Cheng Qiyuan. Ball fired back across the face of goal. Easily dealt with though. Lo Sihon unable to keep that one in play. So the turnover again, Wang Boyin fired it in. It's a lovely touch as well from Yichun. Yichun, well, tried to bat it into the back of the net. Just couldn't get the final direction on the shot. Hong Kong can breathe a huge sigh of relief. There's a nice little touch there from Almaziz. He helps it forwards. It's going to be tireless for the Hong Kong strikers. No more so the win for Manthong, working incredibly hard. Well, a mistake there, just bounced over Ti Man Chun's stick. So a long corner in favour of China. There's the little flick on, just into the path of Wang Xiaowei. However, whistle's gone. Now the little turn from Yu Chiwei wins the hit in. China have been asked to defend a little bit here as well. Lo Sihon
gets dispossessed. It's well won back as well from Wu Tiahui. On the burst, Su Kaijun tees it back up for Wu. Kang Tong Tong keeps it simple. Wang Xiaowei drills it in. Yi Wenhui just looking to try and get a slight deflection but couldn't. Big scoop looking for the run there of Yu Chun Hin. He'll win the hit. Well, the pressure's there from China. Kang Tong Tong, he helps it on. Good stick work there from Lin Chang Liang. He drives into the deep. Well defended again from Hong Kong. That's a little bit rash from Yu Chun Hin. He concedes short corner number five. So China again with another opportunity. It is going to be Yi Wenhui as the injector. Meng Dihao. I'll look to stop this right on the edge. It's a good stop as well. And it's a good calm finish from Gu Haifeng. That's his third of the competition. But he puts China 5-0 up. Good, cool, calm finishing from China, who are starting to impose themselves more and more in this game. Here is the goal scorer. Well, uncharacteristic miscontrol from one of the older age players in the team, age 22. Little nudge results in China getting the ball back. Is Wu. Scoops it out into the wide area. Gu Haifeng helps it down the line. Wang Xiaowei is Yi Wenhui pulls it back and a cool, calm finish. And that is a fantastic team goal from China. Very, very well worked. Well, blink and you're going to miss something here. Lin Tiang Liang gets on the score sheet. His third of the competition after scoring two against Thailand. 6-0 China lead. So good play from China all round. Felix Yao just electing to leave it. Scoop forwards looking for him again. China more than happy to just let that one roll out. And Cheng Chi Yuan gets on with things again. Wu Jiahui, Meng Dihao. China just popping this ball about and making sure it gets to the intended target as well. Change in attack. Su Kaijun doing well. Fires it into the D. That's a lovely skill from Yi Wenhui, who wins yet another
penalty corner. So short corner number six. They've scored from two of them. The percentages are much better, as that looked like a green card being shown. Yoo Chun Hin will go out for 2 minutes. So Lee Wen Hui will inject again. Pulls it back. The scoop forwards again. No nonsense. A cool, calm finish from Chang Tao Tu. Goal number six of the tournament for him. 7-0. China lead. Good word down the flank there from Winfall. Unfortunately, there was no Winfall for him. He went flying over. This means that China win it back. There's a bit of a mistake from Meng Dihao. It's asking an awful lot of Wimple with his work right up front. Cheng Tiyuan being forced all the way back by the officials. Trying to get things back going again with just a fraction over 6 minutes to go. Good pace and a good touch from Yi Wenhui. However, just couldn't lay it off as he wanted. Yi Wenhui driving into the D now. Looks to flick it back inside. Solid defending, and it had to be from Gabriel Soy. Danger not clear yet, though. Tang Tong Tong fires it in. The little left touch coming in, and the finish from Yi Wenhui means that he gets three for the game. China already up to eight. Well, it's another game in open play that will please coach Song Yi. Hit one for San Kin Kan. Fires it into Felix Yao. He wins the hit as well. Big scooping pass. That's going to result in a ball for China. Again, that just a little bit too dangerous as well. So turned straight back over as well. Ferocious drive across from Chang Tao Chu. A little bit of a mistake there from Meng Lei, the skipper. Now the full press on from China as well. Forcing the error from Felix Yao. Utiahui helps it forward. A lovely touch and turn as well from Yutin. Help back inside. The goal not given because the foot was in the way before. So the official blowing for short corner number 7. So China with a chance to extend that lead. Pull back to the edge, it's a great stop as well. The little angle was there. And again, another one before the break. There's 2.5 minutes left. But it is a real dominant display at the moment from China. 9-0 the scoreline, and it is Wang Xiaoyi that gets his name on the score sheet, and that's his first goal of this competition. There's only 2 minutes remaining on the clock. Michael Chung just adjusting himself and sorting himself out in goal. This gives an opportunity for the Hong Kong side to just regroup themselves just before half-time. A few words of encouragement. That's what's needed. So, with just a fraction over 2 minutes left, it's 9-0 already to China. Felix Yao just losing out, the ball flick forwards. It was almost like a game of basketball there, the way that Sankin can control the ball, bouncing it off the turf. The ball scooped forwards, but that's easily dealt with. Wang Xiaowei, the goal scorer, trying to ensure that he can get China going again. There's a little bit of contact. Referee saying that's your final warning. Nice ball fizzed into Su Kaijun. Tries to help it across the face of the D. It's a nice scoop out as well, but poor control from Li Wangqiu. Into the final minute then. China dominating as expected. It's Hong Kong though that will have to regroup themselves at half time and come out and forget that first 35 minutes. Well read on that occasion from Almaziz. Danger not cleared though. Wang Jintian fires it into the D. Gabriel Soy mopping things up. Hong Kong tried to play their way out, but there's just nowhere to go. As China are right in their faces into the final 10 seconds. This is the time for one last effort. On the horn, about to go any second now. And there it is. So it's a comprehensive performance from China in the first 35 minutes. The highlight, a hat-trick from Yi Wenhui. But it has been one-way traffic. The pressure and the pressing game of China that they imposed on this Hong Kong side means that the Hong Kong side trail by 9-0. They'll just have to regroup themselves for the second 35 minutes. It's going to be an uphill task and a tough ask for them. A little bit of spirit required. Half time, Hong Kong 0, China 9.
Very warm welcome back to the Senkang Hockey Complex, where it's Hong Kong that are trailing by 9-0. And the Chinese side just been urged to hurry themselves up to get themselves back, which is exactly what they do. First half hat-trick from Yi Wenhui has been the highlight. Hong Kong, though, electing to rest some of their players. They know that it's going to be a real tough ask for them, as they feel that the big game comes tomorrow when they take on Thailand, which could decide who will finish second in the group. So that is why Hong Kong have started with maybe a couple of players. In fact, there's about four after speaking to a few of the parents down here that have not made today's game. They're trying to be rested as much as possible. Hong Kong straight away on the attack again. Just been having a little ticking off more than anything. So China can look to build from the back. Possession kept from Meng Dihao, drilled into the D, but well defended from Almaziers. Ball cleared, but just not far enough. Flick forwards, it's a lovely turn again from Yi Wenhui, who wins the short corner. Well, it could be a very promising start to the second 35 minutes as well for China. So Yi Wenhui, injector, pulls it to the edge of the D, scoop forwards, that's a better save and a good save from Michael Chung. In fact, they've changed keepers now. It's Chan Kam Tai that has gone back in goal for the second half. So one of the players being given a bit of a shout for the second 35. Meng Lei keeps it simple. Wang Boen does exactly the same. China, you feel, they'll be more than happy just to stroke this one around and keep it simple. Well played from Meng Dihao. Trying to pull it back. Well read on that occasion, though. Well, one advantage played. China break forwards again. That's a poor ball played forwards, though. Easily read and dealt with from Li Wangqi, who was closed very, very quickly. Guqi Xiang got that one completely wrong. Hong Kong give the ball back straight away to China, though. Good stick work means that he finds Yi Wenhui. He wins the long corner. Meng Lei just keeps it simple. Wang Jintian has time as everybody drops off from Hong Kong. Now they start to expand but drop off again. Guqi Xiang looks to switch play. Okay, in a patient game from the Chinese now.
Guti Thiang again. Scoop down the line. Wasn't a bad touch from Chang Chao Tiu, but he did just slip at the crucial moment. So Hong Kong with an opportunity to try and push forwards. Turn in the center from Gao Qixiang. Nicely played forward. Zi Wenhui wins the hit, takes it quickly, gets himself into the. That's brilliant skill. Zi Wenhui just jinking past a couple of defenders, but it was rescued in the end by Almaziez. Again, China not wanting to mess around or hang around here. Ball not stopped. There's a mistake with the hit out, allowing Lin Qiangliang chance to come forward. However, Hong Kong close ranks. Yu Chenhin comes away with the ball but loses possession. Chang Te Tiu down the line. Meng Di Hao trying to work himself into the D, wins the long corner. Tang quickly, a lovely little reverse around the corner. However, the ball just skipping up. Nicely helped on. Fired across goal and almost the faintest of touches from Lin Qiangliang. Finding the back of the net, but just couldn't. So China still looking to get a goal at the start of this second half. Just over 7 minutes in. They're now starting to try and build. Good play, advantage given as well. Fired in. The control from Yu Tian, just getting away from him. Cheng Ti Yuan helps it back inside. Oh, that's brilliant skill. Ball bouncing and popping up. It goes in favour of Yu Chunhin. Stick work on the far side from Felix Yao. Well, it's finished in the Vietnam-Thailand game, and it's finished 11-0 in favour of the Thais. That is a very, very big win, and that will give them a confidence booster ahead of tomorrow's game against Hong Kong. Hong Kong, of course, beat Vietnam by 8-1. Advantage played, hooked away in the end from Chan Kam Tai. It does look as though it's going to boil down to that game tomorrow between Hong Kong and Thailand to see who will progress through Pool A alongside China. That's a lovely little flick back inside. Short corner and a reach for the card as well. It's only green, so it's only going to be 2 minutes off. But short corner number two of this second half for China. We've almost had 10 minutes played as well. If only Hong Kong could have started this way and made it difficult. for China to get anything going. However, they didn't. So Wang Xiaowei entrusted to deliver to the edge of the D. Good pace on it. Scoop forwards. And that is a good finish as well. Fang Jingtian gets his second goal. And he makes the scoreline into double digits. 10-0. It is that China lead. Here China come again. Well, a little flick off the heel. Just a little bit too quick for himself there, Meng Dihao. Quickly, Gabriel Soy tries to scoop it forwards, however danger was there, so the hit given in favor of China. It's a nice ball down the line. Wang Xiaowei. Oh, you could see exactly what Yu Tim was trying to do there. Just flick it around the corner and go again. A 20-year-old not afraid to try something. Wu Tianhui. Oh, well won back. A real chance here now for China to add another one, and that's a stunning individual effort. The reverse strike into the far corner, making absolutely no mistake. And making it 11-0. Yu Tian gets on the score sheet. And boy, oh boy, his second of the game, and a stunning strike to boot. Really, really well played. Well, so far in the two previous games, China have managed to amass 11 goals in each of them. So this three in a row for them. So Hong Kong very much up against it now. There's still just over 22 minutes to go. There's a little nudge in the back, which gives possession back to China. Cheng Qiyuan down the line. Su Lixiang twisting, turning. There was a little bit of contact. Penalty corner being shown. And the stick to boot. So Si Manchun is going to see yellow, so that is going to be a 5-minute break for him. Well, it's not going to argue with the official, he's just going to take the punishment. But another opportunity here for China to add another one. It's a lovely stop and well scooped forwards. Wang Jingtian, he gets his third of the game as well. making absolutely no mistake. That's the same short corner that they have used on the last two occasions, and they've both resulted in goals as well. ...12-0 is the scoreline. As mentioned though, Hong Kong looking forwards to tomorrow's game. They feel that that is going to be the one that will depict and define their outcome in this group. Bit of time and space now. Go Tixiang fires it out wide. Well, that's a lovely play. It's brilliant stick work from Lin Chiang Liang. Did ever so well to get round his man. He still looked to retain possession. China pushing forwards. There was a little bit of contact there, so it's going to be a hit. Wang Jintiang fires it forwards, kicked away from Chen Kamtai. Oh, China hunting impacts now. The discipline there for all to see. And let's not forget that this is the youthful side. Only three players are 22. Everybody else is under the age of 21. They really are looking the side to beat in this competition. Good tracking back, and well done from Meng Lei. Gu Tixiang, he helps it forwards, easily picked off though. And good stick work as well from Felix Yao. And Sang Kan, who tries to force his way all the way through. Gets on with things quickly as well. Looks to fire it in across the face of the D. Looks as though he may have hurt himself slightly there. The way he went to ground, just twisted his ankle, but jumps up and limps back on with things. Go Tixiang finds Wang Jintiang. 18 and a half minutes to go. China very much in the ascendancy. Wang Xiaowei, little layoff from him. Played down the line. The green shirts are queuing up. Hong Kong have to defend here because it's a simple tap-in in the end as the advantage was played by Lin Chiang Liang to make it 13-0. No mistakes whatsoever. And again, it's China that do look as though they are going to go all the way here throughout this competition. This the highest goals tally that they've got so far throughout this tournament. If they want to be the top scorers altogether, they've got to overcome the 14-0 that Thailand beat Cambodia in the women's competition and 14-0 that Kazakhstan beat Cambodia by the same scoreline, so there's still plenty of time left though. So Hong Kong look to try and cause an issue or two. Stopped by Wang Jintiang.
Mingley drills that one forwards. Iwenhui with a little layoff. Well won back from Kang Tong Tong. Another short corner. Can they capitalise? That's the question. So, Iwenhui to deliver again. Good stop. Scoop forwards again. It's another one from a penalty corner. Wang Jingtian gets on the score sheet again. Well, they are picking off Hong Kong at will at the moment. Well, the goals are free-flowing, and it's now 14-0. It is the man that just scored again, Wang Jingtian. Well, he just got away from Cheng Qiwan then, but he did ever so well to recover the situation. Well picked up, one back though from Su Lixiang. And another one, and a card as well to boot. The referee went into his pocket, but it is a ticking off more than anything else. So an opportunity here yet again for Hong Kong to have to defend against the power and the might of this Chinese side. So delivered to the edge of the D. And again, this time just changes the angle. Wang Jingtian just can't stop scoring at the moment. And it's China that do become the top scorers in this competition in a single game, having managed to get a 15th goal. Can Hong Kong sneak a goal? I think would be the best way to describe it. Good stick work there from Yu Qin. Advantage played in favour of Hong Kong as they look to get on with things quickly. Well, it's amazing to think that China have had 12 penalty corners, or the short corners, whichever way you refer to them. 75% has resulted in goals. 9 goals coming from those well-worked set pieces. Hong Kong just unable to handle it. There's a little touch inside. Could this be the little bit of luck that they get? No, it's not. Rescued by Go Hai Feng. Just under 12 minutes to go. Kwok Chun Ting finds Gabriel Soy.
It's a poor ball from Gabriel Soy. Concedes possession far too cheaply. All the time in the world to look around as well. Yuchin, who drives it into the D, looking for that little nick or deflection. It wasn't forthcoming. Trying to get on with things quickly again. There's the little turn. You could see exactly what Lin Qiangliang was doing. China pressing high again. Six players, almost seven players in the opponent's half, applying that press. That's a good little touch as well, an important one as well from Chang Tao Chu. Wang Xiaowei. Oh, the little no-look pass was a good one. Wang again. Just keeps it simple. Ball smashed across from Gu Haipeng. And the favour returned. Impeccable touch, as you would expect from these Chinese young boys. Brilliant stick work and lovely play from Wang Xiaowei. Just a bit overzealous in the challenge there, Gabriel Soy. You do feel that with all the teams that we've witnessed and seen so far throughout this competition, China look as though they're going to be nailed on to go through to a round two of the Hockey World League. And let's not forget, this is the younger side as well. They still have some experienced squad players to bring back in. And you get that right blend of youth and experience. They could be a real threat when it comes to the world stage. And you feel it could be a false ranking of 19th in the world. However, they'll still have to do it on the big stage if they want to increase and improve that ranking. Meng Dihao, he helps it forwards. A little reverse pass and the reverse strike going goalbound hits the post. Well, this could have been more than the 15 that have been scored already. Ball scooped forwards. Well dealt with though. Chang Tao Chu looks to play out from the back. Finds Yu Qin. Just unable to get there. Just a fraction under 8 minutes to go now. Well played. Possession being kept by China. Well, that was just a little bit too heavy. Acknowledged as well by Kang Tong Tong. Sticks flying around everywhere. China come away with a ball. Su Lixiang helps it out wide. Lin Qiangliang into the middle. Lovely stick work. Back to Su. Su drives it in. Pushed away to safety from Yu Qiwai. Strong challenge on that occasion from Lo Sihan. So Hong Kong looking to try and work the channel. Well defended and read again from Cheng Tiwan. Winfall concedes possession. China look to break again. Oh, it's a lovely little touch forwards as well.
Brilliantly into the path of Chang Taotu. Tries to fire it across the face of goal. However, was adjudged to have been a little bit too dangerous. So Hong Kong can come forwards now. And they've got numbers if they use it correctly. It's a nice ball played down the line. Yu Chi Wai gets closed down quickly by Meng Lei. Well, the skipper leading by example at the back. And fires a beautiful ball into the centre of the field. And now there's real danger for Hong Kong. Mendy Hao has options. Back there defending. Lo Si-hon just had to get his stick to it. That's exactly what he did. So again, Hong Kong on the back foot. Yi Wen-hui wins the short corner. Bemusement from San Kin Kan. So with a 75% conversion rate from the penalty corners or the short corners, China will fancy their chances here. The danger man, Huang Jintian, is still hanging around as well. Four goals against Vietnam, one against Thailand. He's already got four in this game, five in this game as well. He's looking for a double hat-trick. It's well played. It's a variation. They tried to play it into the centre to make something happen. However, it hasn't transpired yet. Just caught too much underneath the ball there, Yi Wen-hui. Well won from Meng Di Hao. Just loses out though. Solid from Su Chun Ming. Gabriel Soy helps it forwards into the path of Almaziz. Does well to recover. However, that was hard work from Chang Taotu. Simon Chun. Tried to play the advantage, however, called back by the officials. Can Hong Kong muster a shot on target? That's the question. Namez concedes possession, and China come again. Guti Xiang. A bit of time and space here for Wang Xiaowei. Wins the hit. Trying to get on with things rather urgently. Wang Boen. China happily popping things around now. All the damage is done as we enter the final 2 minutes. It's the time for another late one here. Nice play out wide. They've got four green shirts in the box. Yi Wen-hui just trying to deflect it. Good save from Chan Kam Tai. Long corner. Scooped in dangerously again. Advantage played once more. And the ball obviously has to be stopped.
before play can continue. Kazakhstan will take on Sri Lanka a little bit later on. That's a game in the men's pool B. That will be on pitch number two. Here we'll have Thailand versus Singapore in the women's pool. That will kickstart at 8 o'clock, but this has been a real lesson for Hong Kong as China have totally dominated and looked incredible doing so. 40 seconds remain. Nice ball fizzed across. Surely it's a goal. Brilliant save from Chan Kam Tai. Couldn't rectify the situation though. So the short corner awarded into the final 30 seconds, and you feel that this will be the last bit of action and an opportunity for China to make it 16. So Yi Wenhui to deliver. Just 5 seconds left on the clock. The horn will go momentarily, which it does. So this will be the last bit of action. Everybody forwards for China. It's a good stop, scoop forwards and into the back of the net. And that is the final nail in the coffin for Hong Kong. But as we mentioned, they do have bigger fish to fry tomorrow when they take on Thailand. That will be their make or break game for Pool A. But as it is, it's a very, very comprehensive victory in the end for China, who dominated from the opening minutes and now sit pretty at the top of Pool A, having won all of their games. Unbelievable that they have managed to score two sets of 11. That's 22 and 16 here. 38 goals in three games shows the domination that the Chinese have brought to this tournament and are looking serious about progressing. Final score here, Hong Kong 0, China 16. More action a little bit later with the women. Thailand taking on Singapore. See you in a little while.